Yeah, there is no sound on this, but you can see there, I guess, the
very large impact of that. I think that's the aftermath right there. We're going to re-rack it and show it one more time. Spider, you in particular, if you can watch this and tell us what we're seeing as we're seeing it here, Spider.
Yeah, first of all, notice the terrain. It's very restrictive. So when you have a concussive blast like that, it's going to be contained within an increasingly smaller area. So the force and the blast is just exacerbated based on where it's striking. Also, bear in mind, this was a tunnel complex. So again, as that shock wave goes underground and gets into those different tunnels, it's constricted. And you can only imagine anybody who's down there is now turned to dust.
It's hard to see on the video there, but we know that this fell into a deep mountain valley. There's mountain ridges surrounding the area, and this complex of caves and tunnels was deep in a valley surrounded by these steep mountains. So it's one of the ways that they could keep an eye on the target in the days leading up to this and try to ensure that there were no civilians in the area. That shot you see right there is a better look at this region, which is so mountainous and so remote. So it falls into this deep mountain valley, and the mountains surrounding it certainly, I think you can say, would have absorbed some of the blast, which also would have kept damage contained from any other civilian areas nearby. There are, at a distance, some villages, some areas where there are people, but troops on the ground this morning say they see no signs of civilian casualties.